Yes, please. So the CDC and the FDA last week changed their recommendations for folks who are immunocompromised. There's a list on the next slide in a minute when I show it that shows an illustrative list of who may be in this. In the Commonwealth of Kentucky, I have determined with our department that the Kentucky Department for Public Health will deem every resident of a long-term care facility to be eligible under this criteria. We had, for the vast majority of our journey in 2020 and early 2021, two-thirds of all of our deaths occurred in long-term care facilities, two-thirds. And now it's gotten less than that now as the deaths have gone to other populations and the vaccinations have protected so many of these folks. But because of their medically frail condition often and the environment they live in a congregate setting, we are determining that all of these individuals in a nursing home are going to be eligible for vaccination for a third dose and will be offered a third dose, and that is already underway now and beginning. For everyone else in the general population, these are the individuals, people with these type of conditions, who are identified as being eligible. This is not an exhaustive list. There will be others who may qualify. I encourage you to talk to your healthcare provider, talk to your physician or primary care provider, and ask them, do they think you are immunocompromised under this criteria? And if so, when you go and present yourself to get your third dose of either Moderna or Pfizer, you need only attest that you have a immunocompromised condition. No one's going to double check or verify. You need only attest to this and get this. Now, this is not a general purpose booster dose for all the rest of us. Currently, the evidence does not yet say it's necessary for those of us with intact immune systems to get a booster dose. Now, the media here in the room and others probably see the headlines just like I do. There's some talk about whether the Biden administration will go forward and change the recommendations as early as September about a third dose for a booster. We're not there yet. We'll update you as soon as we have firm information on that. But for right now, all of these individuals, if you fit in these criteria, I encourage you to go to a local pharmacy. If your primary care doctor is doing vaccinations, your hospital, your health department, and get your third dose, because you may not have had an adequate response to the first two doses, whereas those of us who have intact immune systems are probably still in pretty good shape.